Hey Mom, we decided to make this video for your birthday because we know that you don't like big parties. We just wanted to have something special for you to look back on as this really special day.
One of the funnest things that we have done in recent years is discover wine tasting. It's been so fun, so relaxing, especially when it's just the two of us. It just gives me time to love you and enjoy you and enjoy some really great tasting wines together. It's been great. Thank you. I love you for this. Bye.
Mom, some great memories I have are doing all the camping trips up here to go to Morningstar conferences. They were always a lot of fun for me, and you always made sure we had a great time then and when we moved up here, going to church and all the other conferences and activities we had with them. Love you. Merry Christmas.
Mom, some of the really memorable experiences we had when we were homeschooled were really, really awesome projects. One of them was when we did the map of the USA that took up the entire kitchen floor. And a couple others were when we were dissecting insects and crazy cow eyes and frogs and everything else, going into trips, the Starkey Nature Park.
Finding owl pellets.
And all of those fun things that took the classroom outside. You were the best teacher ever.
Staring at the blank page before you, open up the dirty window, let the sun illuminate the words that you could not find.
Mom, my favorite food you ever made me, to this day, is lasagna.
Thank you, Mom, for introducing me to the beautiful world of mashed potatoes. They will always be my first love. However, I can't get enough of your zucchini casserole.
You captured my heart with your love, but you really captured my heart with your food. You know what I mean. You're the best cook ever.
So, I had a really hard time thinking about what was my favorite dish that you made. And then Angela said, if Mom could only make you one more dish for the rest of your life, what would it be? You make the best steak ever, and you make it just medium, rare, just perfect, and level of light. Enjoyed all of our family trips to Blood Mountain, especially the rope swing that was always there until the last year when it mysteriously disappeared.
Most of our family vacations when we were younger were spent at Fort DeSoto Beach. We just wanted to say thank you for introducing us to the lovely Florida waters, especially the manatees that we saw in the little cove, and fishing, catching our first fish, and finding sand dollars.
And watching Dad chase a raccoon with a whole loaf of bread.
We love you.
Best vacation ever was Cozumel, start to finish. 5 days, even though you think it was six. I remember the Jeep that almost broke down, snorkeling from the coast, just a beautiful hotel that we stayed in, the sailing, it was all awesome. It was worth waiting for.
So, my favorite vacations were when we went to Mexico and New York together. Mexico wasn't really a vacation, but it was an experience that I'll never forget. The very first time I ever went on a mission trip was with my best friend. And then New York was also an experience I'll never forget, getting lost on the subways, figuring out our way around. It was the most fun I think I've ever had on a vacation. And that crazy time we went to that comedy club, that was way too inappropriate for a 17-year-old. I put Panama on here because it was a trip you weren't on, but I don't think I could have made it home without you. Between being sick and not having a flight for some reason or whatever the problem was, it was because of you that I came home alive. So thank you.
I moved to North Carolina was kind of difficult for me, leaving all my friends and the place where I grew up, and you were a big part of being supportive and caring and understanding at that time in my life, and I really appreciate you being there for me. Okay.
So you have been there for all of my milestones in my life. I want to thank you especially for being there for me in the past 2 years, where I have finally realized what I want to do with my life in this crazy, beautiful world that I want to immerse myself in. Thank you for supporting me, for encouraging me, for celebrating with me every day. Depending on how hard or how easy it is, you encourage me to go forth with this dream that I have. Thank you for being my inspiration.
You were one of the two people that really supported me through all of my crazy phases. And music wasn't really a phase, it was part of my life. You always supported me through my voice lessons, through my musicals, and through anything that had to do with leading worship. You were my number one fan, and I really appreciated every moment.
I think my best birthday ever with you was my 60th birthday. It was just so sweet and so special. Even though the hot tub wasn't hot, it was still a great birthday. Thank you for making it so special.
Oceaneering was a very trying chapter in my life, and you always were there for me to talk and console me and just encourage me to keep on going, and I really appreciate you being there for me in this time of my life.
For my whole life, you've been there for me, through the good and the bad. Thank you for being there for me when I lost my baby. Thank you for being there for me when I was scared, when I didn't know what to do, when I thought that I couldn't raise someone alone by myself. Thank you for reminding me that we are a family and that you will always love me no matter what I get myself into. Thank you so much for reminding me that I am strong and that I can handle anything with God behind me. And thank you even more so for getting me excited about life.
1999 was a very special year. But it wasn't really a great year. Thank you for being there for me, helping me pull through it, and for everything else that was going on in our life. Thank you so much.
So, when I was going through hard times, it was always with conversations that meant the world to me, you taking time out of your day to stop and talk to me, whether it was a breakup that I had and we went to a coffee shop and had to sit outside and just sit there, maybe not even talk very much, but it was the time that mattered. Or whether it was a little baby in my belly that I lost, and it was just the sitting on the back deck talking or not talking or crying or not crying that was really helping me get through those hard times. Those are just some examples, but it was those times where you were just talking or not talking. It was just the two of us that really meant a lot to me. Feel the rain on your skin. No one else can feel.
Some of my favorite memories from growing up is when I had a lot of birthday parties at my house that you helped host and make food for, and you enjoyed me and my friends running around like crazy animals playing manhunts.
Not quite sure what's happening here, but it seems that the older we get, the funnier we get, especially you. I just love laughing with you.
So I'm supposed to talk about my memories that make me really happy. Thank you for always making sure that no matter how much money we had, my outfits for ballet looked just as good as the other little girls. Thank you for going with me to new dance classes where I was scared and nervous about meeting new people. Thank you for being at all my recitals. Thank you for being behind the stages with me, helping me do my hair, and making sure that all my ribbons were in place. Thank you for being there for me when I bought my first pair and my last pair of pointe shoes that made my toes completely miserable. Thank you for encouraging me still, in my old age with my bad knees, to dance everywhere I go and live my life like no one else is watching and it's just me.
So one memorable memory I have from childhood is that anytime I had a bad dream, if I was really little, I would just come crawl in bed with you and you would let me, and then eventually walk me back and try to teach me how to be responsible or a big girl. Yeah. But another thing I thought was really awesome from my childhood is that anytime I had a dream, I would tell you about my dream, and then you would pray with me and encourage me to find out what the dream meant. And it was funny because a lot of my dreams when I was little, for some reason, were like attacks from who knows where. And you prayed with me, and I remember in my dreams attacking after that, attacking whatever it was in my dream that was attacking me and winning. And I think it was because of you that I was able to conquer those fears in my dreams.
Okay, so one of our favorite memories that all of us have combined is Alfonso Alligator. Not the football team. And his amazing stories that encouraged us with character to be better people. Thank you, Mom, for incorporating your creativity and your love for us into such wonderful stories. You took time each night out of your busy life to make sure that we were happy and had beautiful dreams when we went to bed.
So, honey, we just wanted to do this little presentation to let you know how much we love you and appreciate you, every one of us. And we just want to, we can't say enough in these few moments to let you know what you mean to us, to every one of us.
We love you.
We love you.
We love you.
Happy
birthday.
Happy birthday.
Staring at the blank page before you open up the dirt.